that everyone called her Little Red Riding Hood. One morning, Little Red Riding Hood's mother told her to put on her cloak and take a basket of butter made to her grandmother, who was ill and lived on the opposite side of the forest. While she was on her way, up came a big wolf and said,
"Good morning, Little Red Riding Hood. Where are you going in such a hurry?"
"I'm taking this basket to my grandmother, who is ill and lives at the edge of the wood."
"But why don't you stop and listen to the birds and pick some flowers?"
So the wolf left Little Red Riding Hood picking flowers while he hurried on to the house at the edge of the wood, where he found grandmother, ate her up, put on her clothes, jumped into bed, and waited for Little Red Riding Hood to come.
"There she is now. Open the latch and walk in."
"Hello, Grandmother. I've brought you some butter and eggs." "Oh, Grandmother, what big eyes you have."
"The better to see you with, my child."
"Oh, Grandma, what large ears you have."
"The better to hear you with, my child."
"Oh, Grandma, what terrible big teeth you have."
"The better to eat you with."
With that, the wolf jumped from the bed and would have eaten Little Red Riding Hood all up had it not been for her father, a woodcutter, and his dog, who heard the noise, ran in, and chopped off the wolf's head before he could do any harm. Then the birds began to sing because they knew that the bad wolf was dead and that Little Red Riding Hood was safe and sound in her father's arms on her way home.